So I was about to record this tutorial yesterday, but my friend texted me and he was like, yo, I want to practice my motorcycle riding skills, and he's kind of beginner inside this. And if you don't know, I'm very passionate about motorcycles. I never miss opportunity in my life to ride a bike. So I was like, yo, I'm down for it. And I'll finish also the photo shoot with you, which was interrupted by some urgent stuff that we need to do. And basically in the thumbnail, you can see his true emotions. So that was the first time that he stood on his bike, and it was crazy. So just a story about the thumbnail that you saw. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can place your text behind subject or behind object. So call it whatever, object, subject. So in our example, we're going to place our text behind our motorcycle guy. So let's jump into Photoshop and I will show you what you need to do. So I already imported our image, and what we want to do is we want to type something. Let's type, for example, word biker. Okay, let's reposition this. Let's make it a little bit smaller. So press Ctrl T and resize it like so. And let's place it. Let's place it like this, just for this tutorial. What we want to do next is we want to turn off the layer with our text and go back to the background layer. And let's zoom in a bit. And for selection, we have a few options. So object selection tool, quick selection tool, and also the magic wand tool. And we're gonna use the combination of object selection and quick selection. So let's go with object selection and let's click on our object. At this case, it's a subject, I believe. And if we want to add, so basically we can select only the motorcycle or only the guy. So what we want to do is we want to hold shift. It will add a little plus sign, and we can click now on a bike too. So it will make selection from the boat. And we have this issue. So let me zoom in a bit. This issue where our hand is off the selection and also parts of the bike. So we will use quick selection tool for this. And by default, it's on minus. So you can change it here. So to add. So, and we're going to refine our selection a bit like so. Also, I want to add hand. I want to add the mirror here. Something like so. And if we hold Alt, we will get the minus icon. So I don't want to add this part here. I want to add also this part. And at this point, I think I'm happy with my selection. So what we want to do is we want to turn on our text layer here, click on it, hold Alt and click on a create mask. So we will have mask created for our text layer. And if we go and so this is our mask. If you hold Alt and click on a mask, you will see the mask itself. So we have something like this, but you can see that there is definitely we need to refine some places. For example, if we go, let me show you. If we go here, you can see that it's not that good. Also this part here, let me go back a bit. So also this part where K should go through. So what you want to do is you want to select your mask and pick a brush tool, and you want to go and zoom on a parts that you want to work with and select the brush tool and start to brush in our leather. So you can go and refine the edges. So your accuracy depends on what you want to do. If I was going to create the thumbnail for YouTube, this result that we have here is more than enough for that particular case. But if you want to go and refine stuff, you can go and choose the white color to add parts of your letters, and you can choose black to erase on our mask. So if you go with white, you're adding, and if you go with black, you're erasing. So this is it. And at this point, well, let's assume that you refined your mask and you want to replace the text. Well, reposition, not replace. And if you go like this, it's not working correct. And what you want to do for that is you want to unlink your mask from the text. I'm clicking on this icon here, and you can see I'm on a mask, and I'm replacing the mask here. Click on the text, and now you can move the text layer and the mask will stay. So if you want to like reposition this, for example, you want to reposition this like so, you can do it. And let's just click here, and now our mask will stay. So this is it for today's tutorial. Now you know how to place your text behind an object or behind someone. And if you like this video, leave a like, it will help a ton, sub to the channel, and I will see you in the next one. And also you can like leave your comments in a comment section down below and let me know what you want to see next. Till then, stay awesome.